Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're well. Today I thought I would share with you my skin secrets to getting clearer skin. These are just the products that I like to use sometimes all the time and then sometimes just when I'm getting a breakout. So I thought I'd share with you guys just the things that I like to do and the products that I like to use when I feel like my skin is having a bit of a traumatic time. So the first thing I want to mention, I hope it doesn't sound like too much of an obvious step, but I always make sure I wash my hands as much as I possibly can. If you're using a foaming cleanser or if you're using a balm or anything that you're taking your makeup off with where you're not using cotton wool pads, then always make sure to wash your hands before you start taking anything off. Wash your hands before you put on your makeup. Wash your hands before you put on any moisturiser or any kind of lotions that you're putting on your skin. Just always make sure to keep your hands really clean, because obviously if you've got germs or if you've just touched a spot and then you're going to start putting your fingers all over your face, then you're only going to spread that. And so keeping your hands nice and clean is a really great first step to try and keeping your skin clear. The next thing I would suggest is try and clean your makeup brushes once a week. We are always going to have weeks where we may forget or we just can't be bothered. You know, I'm not saying that you have to religiously always make sure you clean your makeup brushes every week. Sometimes I'll forget, sometimes I'll be sitting on Twitter on a Sunday evening and someone will mention that they haven't cleaned their makeup brushes and I think, oh my god, I haven't done mine for like 2 weeks. But when you're specifically suffering from a really bad breakout, then I think it's really important to, you know, have in the back of your mind that you need to clean your makeup brushes, because if you have got any blemishes, especially sort of like really big acne ones, you know, they're only going to spread if you keep using that same applicator to brush on your foundation. Then you're just brushing it into areas of your skin that are not necessarily infected. And I try and maintain the same concealer for under my eyes and a different one for blemishes, because I don't really want to be putting something under my delicate eye area that I've just put on a spot. That's just my personal opinion. You don't have to, you know, do that. You don't have to specifically go out and buy a different concealer, but that would be a suggestion if you're looking at clearing things up. I just don't like the idea of putting the same concealer under my eyes and onto my spots. And also, if I'm suffering from a really, really nasty spot, which I often do, I usually try and use a brush as opposed to the sponge that they usually put on a concealer, you know, doe foot applicator. I usually try and just scrape the product off of the stalk instead of using the applicator, because a brush I can wash, whereas the applicator I'm probably not likely to wash. And if you've got a really sore one and you don't really want to spread it, I would just suggest just putting a tiny little bit of that in the tube or off the stalk and just applying it with a brush, and then making sure you're washing this brush as much as you can. As you can see, I haven't washed that much. I'm going to start talking about products now, because I want to start moving on to sort of my routine for blemish prone skin. And I do find, because of a medical condition, I do have very teenage skin. Even though I'm 25, coming up for 26 now, I feel like my skin is probably the worst that it's been for a very, very long time, probably since I've been 16. It's always been bad and it will probably always be bad, but I try and find products or ways that I can try and prevent it from getting worse, or, you know, trying to keep it at bay. And my favourite product that I've been using, and which I've banged on about in videos and in blog posts before, is the La Roche-Posay F.A. Clar range. I just find it super effective and also super gentle, and that's the most important thing, because I think in the past I may have used products that are really drying on the skin, thinking that that's going to be the best solution. And I sometimes watch videos or I'll read blog posts where people say, you know, don't be afraid to put oils on your skin if you've got oily skin, or don't be afraid to put moisturiser on when you're having a breakout. And I do agree with that to an extent. I don't personally like using oils too much on my face, because I do find, as an oily skin person, that it just doesn't do me any good. I think you have to be really careful with things like that. But these products that I'm going to mention are so gentle and they're so effective, and they're not even particularly expensive. So I just thought I'd give you a rundown of the products I use, not only when I'm feeling like I've got a hideous, you know, load of blemishes, but I also use them to try and keep them at bay. So I constantly use these products. And although as a blogger I do like to change up my skincare routine and my makeup, if I know something works for me really well, there's not much chance that I'm going to change it up. I might try something different, but if it isn't as effective, then I'm just going to go back to that product. The first step in my routine, morning and evening, is the F.A. Klar Foaming Cleanser, and I believe I mentioned this in my May favourites. It's just really great, and I'm most of the way through it by now. I can't describe how, you know, all of these products have really, really helped me so much in times where I just feel like there wasn't much hope for me. I just couldn't use anything and they just couldn't clear things up. And I'm not really sure what started me on La Roche-Posay, but I ended up picking it up and I'm so glad I did. They're so gentle, so effective. I do find French pharmacy brands just really great to use, really inexpensive. They're all, you know, you've got to look out for a dermatologically tested product if you're looking at trying to clear up your skin, because you know those products have been tested on people with sensitive skin, rosacea, you know, problem prone skin, and it says it's tested on imperfection prone skin, so I know that it's going to be gentle and effective because that's what they've said. So I use this in the morning and the evening, and I think it's really important to say that you should cleanse your face in the morning as well as take your makeup off in the evening. You know, if you don't do that, then it's probably a step that you should be doing. I always make sure I cleanse my face in the evening and in the morning, and I know it probably seems like you're overdoing it, but cleansing your face in the morning is just as important as cleansing your face in the evening and taking your makeup off. And this is really effective at taking my makeup off. I will literally just like splash my face with water, put this in the palm of my hands, it foams up really nicely. It starts as a gel, and then you foam it up in your hands, just foam it around the skin, and then take a muslin cloth and just take it off with that, or just a, you know, a normal flannel, a normal face cloth, anything like that will do, as long as you're getting the product off and making sure that you've got the whole lot off. That sort of brings me on to my next point, and I know this again sounds really simple, but just making sure you're keeping, if you're using a flannel, use a different flannel every day. I like to use a muslin cloth, and I like to use one that's sort of quite gritty, if that makes sense, like quite rough, because you know you're going to get a bit of exfoliation in there as well, and that's also really great for getting into the pores and getting the product off properly. And if you're using a muslin cloth, I think I probably have 4 or 5, and I just make sure I change them every week. I don't necessarily change them every day because I feel like I'd be doing too much washing that way, but what I do try and do is after I've used it and rinsed it out, I then rinse it through with some antibacterial soap, and so I know that there's nothing sort of sitting on there that's going to be too nasty when I'm going to use it the next day or later that evening or whatever. So just try and perhaps run it through with a bit of soap if you don't wash it every day. So I think that's probably a really great thing to do. Alternatively, if you're using flannels, then you can pretty much wash them and go, really. So yeah, just trying to keep what you're washing your face with really clean, and this is a really great cleanser if you're looking for a cleanser for problem prone skin. The next step in my routine, also again day and night, I will go over after I've cleansed my face with the F.A. Klar, it's called Lotion Extringent Micro Exfoliate, and it just tightens and helps unblock pores. Now, I've mentioned this in my June favourites, and I think I said in there that once I used this, once I started using it, I was really not sure about it. I didn't think it was as gentle or, you know, as nice feeling as any of the other La Roche-Posay products. I felt like it was slightly too harsh for my skin. But after using it for, I've probably been using it about 2.5-3 weeks maybe, perhaps even a little bit more than that, I've just found this so, so effective. I actually suffer quite a lot with, and I may have mentioned it before, but quite red cheeks. It's not necessarily that there's spots there, but it's just always slightly red. and my pores are always very big, and this has just helped, just made them so tiny, and it's cleared up any redness that I feel I'm getting on my cheeks. It also is keeping my spots at bay just so well. I mean, the products that I'm mentioning here are super effective, but I felt like I needed something more. And once I bought this, I realised this is what I was missing in my routine, because this just, not only does it help with spots to dry them up, but it also has just, I'd say about two and a half weeks now, I haven't had a massive breakout. And I am putting it down to this product, because I think it's really great. I just think it's super effective. And although I felt like it was too harsh at first, I don't feel like it dries out my skin. It doesn't actually say on the back whether you should use it morning and evening, but I have been using it morning and evening. I'm just doing it after I've cleansed. The only thing I will say is that it says not to use it under your eye area, because obviously that skin is quite delicate, which says to me that this product is probably quite harsh, but I don't feel like I've got majorly dry skin after I use it, and actually my skin feels really refreshed, and it just looks a lot nicer, it just looks a lot healthier, and it's just keeping everything right at bay. So I've been really loving using that. The next product I want to talk to you guys about is actually the sort of like more like things that you like lotions that you put on your skin. It's the F.A. Clar Duo Plus and the F.A. Clar AI, and this is how they look if you're going to buy them on the shelves. Just a little bit of a smaller one and quite a thin box, but these are brand new, so I thought I'd show you how they look if in case you want to go and pick them up from Boots or wherever. But this is how they actually come out of the pack. We've got the F.A. Clar Duo and the F.A. Clar AI, and I'm pretty much out of this, and as you can see I'm squeezing the life out of this. And this is the F.A. Clar AI, and it's a targeted breakout corrector, and I actually started my collection with this, and I'd got a spot on my cheek right here, and I often suffer with very, very sore acne spots around my cheeks, which can be a very difficult thing to cover. I don't tend to use any kind of, I will literally just use foundation, concealer and loose powder over the top. I never use any blush or highlighter when I'm going through these times. I feel like sometimes when you've got them on your chin, you can get rid of them. Currently I'm sporting one on the top of my forehead at the moment, but I can cover that up with a fringe, so I'm not bothered about that. But the only time I really find I'm really bothered about spots is when they're on my cheeks, because I just find them, I know this is personal to everyone, but I feel like when I've got spots that the whole world is looking at them, and I'm sure everyone feels that way, and I'm sure they're not as bad as what you've got them in your mind at, but I just, that's just the way I feel. And so it kind of gets me down really when I have got a terrible breakout, because I don't really feel like going out, I don't really feel like, you know, doing anything. There have been months, well not months, but well, yeah, actually there was a month where I didn't blog the whole time because my skin was just so bad. I just couldn't get my head around doing photographs, trying new products. I didn't really want to talk about anything because it was just really getting to me, and it was just making me really sad. So it's not nice when you are suffering with that. You know, I am sort of in my mid-20s now. I'm still suffering from it. It's just part of life, unfortunately, and you know, we do get days where we're going to feel sad about it, but everyone feels that way, so don't worry about it if you're really driving yourself up the wall because you know you've got a big spot, and they often happen when, you know, you least want them to happen, i.e. you've got something coming up, or you're going out, or you've got a day, or whatever. But, you know, just try not to let yourself get too down about it, but also indulge yourself if you are feeling a little bit sorry for yourself, because we also all feel like that. So, back to the products. F.A. Clar AI is the first thing I tried, and like I say, I had a really terrible spot right in there, and I used the product on here for like a day and it totally cleared it up. And I was just so put off by the fact that this is a cream, not like a gel, because I think when you associate products that are good for blemish prone skin, you either think you've got to put some kind of like drying agent on it, which for a cream I don't think that's naturally what you associate it with. I think if you're thinking about spots, you want to dry them out, and the only way you're going to dry them out is by using tea tree oil or some kind of tea tree product or some kind of gel or scrubs. I used to, before I started using this, I used to use a Neutrogena scrub, and my god, why was I ever using that? Even though it's a daily scrub, I was probably really scrubbing away good parts of my skin, and now I just try and concentrate on good products that are dermatologically tested, you know, tested for sensitive skin, say, or tested on imperfection prone skin. They're the best kind of products that you want to use. So let's get back to it, because I keep, you know, going off subject. But I'd started using this, and then I don't know why, but I didn't pick it up again. It was probably because it was a cream. It was probably the smell. It is very strange. And also, I don't really like, oh no, it's gone missing. But on the packaging on this, you get a little like push down thing where you have to push down to get the product out, and like you might not be able to see it very clearly there, but half the blooming product is in the lid, which is my only gripe about all of this range, is that this is not made very well. Let me just see if I can get it out of my new box, because I really want to show you guys like what I mean. Yeah, see, this one's got it. Can you see it? You have to like push it and twist it around to get the product out, but really, what is the point of this? Why would I need to push anything in? Surely it's just better to just have it as a tube and then just keep it so that you, when you squeeze it, the product comes out. But I just found that far too much product was coming out in the lid, and it was a little bit wasteful. So I will say that about it. It's probably my only criticism that I can think of. But now I do use this. I use it every day. Again, coupled with this, after I have used the lotion, I will then go over all my skin, regardless of whether it's got blemishes on it or not, with the FA Clar Duo. And this is a corrective unclogging care, and also it's supposed to get rid of little dark marks or, you know, scars where you've picked them, which, you know, we all do. And this is really great also for keeping things at bay. I just find this is really great for not just when you're suffering, but also after you've suffered. And it's just, I make sure I apply it morning and evening, again, morning and evening, after I've cleansed and whatever else. And you can put that on the whole of your face, and make sure you do put it on the whole of your face, not just where you feel like you're going to get a spot or you feel like you're clogging up a little bit. The only thing, again, I'm not trying to find fault, but I would use this. I find this just a really great base of makeup, and I also don't feel like I need to moisturise as much when I'm using this. But the only thing I feel like is missing is perhaps if you was to turn it into sort of more of a product where you could put it on and it be a moisturiser, is a bit of SPF. That's the only thing I think that this is missing, is just a little bit of SPF in it, and then I'd be set for the day, really. But then I will usually go over any spots that I've got that are prominent after I've used this to the whole of my face. I'll go over with the FA Clar AI just to get rid of any blemishes. And this usually clears it up, I think, within sort of 2 to 3 days, which is not too bad. It instantly takes down any redness. So even if sometimes I'm suffering a little bit around, like the corners of my nose or just on my cheeks a little bit, I'll just pop a bit of that on and it instantly takes down the redness. These are really great products if you've already got sort of like a nice cleanser and a nice toner that you already enjoy, and you just want something to just help clear everything up. These two are really great. This one's about £15. I think this one might be about the same, which, you know, obviously you get a lot more in this, but they work together so nicely. I personally don't feel like this range is particularly expensive, and the other day I went in and it was 3 for 2, so they do 3 for 2 on also the French pharmacy bits as well. And although buying them all together might seem like quite an extravagant purchase, if you was buying a high-end product and you'd want to see these kind of results, i.e. Clinique or what else, like Clarins, something like that, then you'd pay a lot more, and you probably, I don't feel, get the same results. So I feel like they're, you know, fairly inexpensive and also really effective, very gentle. So I really don't think you can go wrong with them. A great moisturiser for oily skin is the No. 7 Beautiful Skin Day Cream, which is for normal to oily skin. So if you do suffer from blemishes, this is a really great product if you want to give that a go. It's got SPF and it's also got 5-star UVA, so it's really good for protecting your skin from the sun. We should all try and moisturise, I'm sure, but if you've got oily skin anyway, then you're slightly better off than someone that's got dry skin, because the natural oil is already there and your skin's overproducing the oil. So I would suggest don't over moisturise too much, but if you're having a dry day, then just pop a little bit of this on. I don't find it breaks me out, so I find this a really effective moisturiser. I've also got a little scrub. It's sort of a scrub. Well, it's a face mask, but it's got a little scrub in it as well. It's the Soap and Glory 2-in-1 Pore Purifying Mask and Peel. And it's basically a mask which you can use for sort of 15 minutes, or it's a mask that you can just use for 5 minutes. And it's got the typical sort of Soap and Glory scent to it. It's kind of pepperminty, and it just looks like that. It's sort of like a greeny colour, but you can, I don't know if you can see, but it's got like tiny little exfoliating beads in it. And this is supposed to be for your pores, but I often find when I do have like a really terrible spot, if I pop that on and I leave it on for 15 minutes, then the spot will be very much improved the next day. So I like to use that, you know, in the evenings if I feel like I'm having a bit of a bad time with it. So that's a really great little product to use. Another mask that I really love using when I'm having a really terrible skin time is the number 7 Beautiful Skin Purifying Mask, and it's again specially for oily to normal skin. If you see anything, I'm pretty sure within a green, it's like a light greeny colour box, then that is the number 7 specific oily skin type products. I think the really dry stuff is pink. So if you're on the, I just find number 7 a really great brand. I find their skincare really nice. I always find it super effective. And they're usually, again, they're usually on a 3-for-2 offer. Boots a lot of the time have an offer on their skincare or their makeup where you can mix and match. Or alternatively, if you've bought something in Boots recently, then you've probably got a voucher, and the vouchers are usually pretty good. And I picked this up again when I was having some really terrible troubles. And this is just a, it says it's hypoallergenic, so I know it's going to be nice and sensitive for my skin. It says it's a gentle thermal mask, which is ideal for blemish prone skin. And basically, this is like a scrub and a mask. Again, very similar to the Soap and Glory. I'd say that's a pretty good alternative if you don't want to spend this sort of money, because I know the number 7 things can be quite expensive. But this is again very similar in that it comes out like a scrub, but as soon as you apply it, you're supposed to wet your face first, and then as soon as you apply it, it heats on contact. So that just means it warms up on your skin, and then you start scrubbing it round, and you do leave it on as a mask. But things that are good, the reason this is good for your skin is that because it's hot, it opens up the pores and it's going to draw out any kind of impurities that you've got. So if you feel like you've got a little under the skin spot and you're like, when's it going to come out? Try something like this, because it's just going to draw it right out, and hopefully it's going to clear it right out. But I always find my skin is extra baby smooth after a baby smooth or baby soft after I've used this. It's just got such a nice texture to it. So even when I'm not really having bad skin, I just sometimes I like to use this just to get rid of some dead skin, and also because it just leaves my skin really nice and soft. So I really like using that. This has gone on to slightly more products than I thought I would talk about, but I thought I'd also share with you some more sort of like little tips. And the next thing I'm going to say is, if like me you don't change your bedclothes every week, I just find it far too time consuming, and sometimes it's just too much hard work. So I don't change my bed covers every week, but I do change my pillows over. Now, if you don't want to wash them every week, then a really easy way to just keep them nice and fresh is just to turn them over. So instead of using the side that you've got on at the moment, just flip it over, because sometimes things like pillows can harvest a lot of germs, and if you're sleeping on them every night, that's why I think sometimes I get quite bad cheek spots, because if they've got loads of germs on them and you keep sleeping on them, you're only going to infect your face more. So definitely try changing your pillows or try turning your pillowcases over. If you lie on four pillows, which I do, then it's really great because you can just flip over, flip over, flip over, flip over, and then you don't have to watch bed covers, which is probably really grim, but hey ho. Also, another great tip is on your mobile phone. This lovely little case that you buy can sometimes harvest lots of germs. And if you take, if you don't want to replace your screen protector thing, or you don't have one on, then an antibacterial wipe just every once a week, every couple of weeks, just over the phone is really great, because when you're holding it up to your ear, you know, if you've got things going on there, then you're just going to keep spreading it. So just give your phone a little wipe with a little antibacterial wipe. And the last thing that I'm going to suggest, which I actually think is my most, maybe my most effective, probably my most effective has been the lotion recently, but my second most effective thing that I feel like I've been doing, that's just made a lot of difference to just brightening up my skin, clearing up my skin, is actually just having a bit of lemon in water. And I am currently drinking it like this at the moment. It's, I've just been trying to drink loads of water because I'm just trying to clear out my skin, but also just having a bit of lemon with it. Lemon is supposed to be good for your skin anyway, and I've just found it clears up my skin, just, and it's just like a really natural way of doing things. You know, you're not adding extra calories, you're not putting anything on your skin, but I just find lemon really effective in some water, or even if you're having it in your Pepsi or whatever, you know, just try and do a little bit of lemon in a drink, and I just find it's just cleared up my, personally it's cleared up my skin a lot better than what I thought it would. I just thought I'd give it a try. Hopefully that's provided you guys, if you are suffering at the moment, with some extra little, not secrets I wouldn't say, but just some tips and tricks and products that I use. And if they can be effective for me, then hopefully they can be effective for you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or any comments, then I'll leave all my social information, social media information down below. And just feel free to tweet me, or you can follow me on Instagram, or you can comment on my blog or whatever. I will always come back to you if you've got any questions whatsoever. But I hope you've enjoyed this video, guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.